Hello students, welcome back to the next session on your file data file handling. Here let us know about the hierarchy of file stream classes. You already know what you mean by file IO functions. So the base, the header file that you require is IO stream. From this you can go for your iStream. You know what you mean by your iStream, input stream. You can go for your OStream, that is your output stream, and then from this again the IO stream. Okay, and again you can go for your if stream, and you can get off stream from here, and you have your F stream. Okay, and for all this you have a base, that is F stream base. From the S stream you have your if stream, F stream and off stream. If stream is for your input, off stream is for your output, and F stream is both for input and output, that we have already learned. So now what is this F stream base? What do you mean by this F stream base? F stream base means it combines all the file streams, whatever is there comes under this F stream. That is, this is the base class. This is the base class for your F stream, if stream and off stream. Okay, so the next that you have F stream, if stream and off stream classes. It also contains the open and close functions. Okay, this is about your if stream base. Now in the same way you have your if stream, right? So what is this if stream? What is the use of this if stream? What function does it perform? So it creates a file. It creates the file object for input operation. Remember, I means input, for input operation. I is your input, F is your file. Okay, I stands for input and F stands for your file, input file stream. So if stream creates a file object for your input operation. So this will have the get function, the get line function, all these you have learned last year, right? So get line, read, seek g and tell g. Seek g, tell g functions and all will come across later, we'll explain them. So all these functions comes under your if stream. Remember, this is an important part, because this, they ask this question for 2 marks. Mention all the functions of if stream. So when they ask this question, you have to tell that get line, read, seek g and tell g are the functions that comes under your if stream. If you write just this much, you get your 2 marks. So the next stream is your off stream. So what is this off stream? This off stream creates a file object for your output operation. For output operation, so as we said earlier, O means output and again if means file, output file stream. So it creates a file object for your output operation. So under this you have your put function, write function, seek p and tell p are the functions of your O stream. Again, this is a 2-mark question. Mention the different functions that comes under your off stream. Okay, and the next stream in this is your F stream. So this is your, as we said, F means file. So this contains both the input and the output. Both are contained together in this stream. So it provides a simultaneous read and write operations. So all the functions of the I stream, O stream, IO stream objects will be present in this F stream. The next most important section of this chapter is type of data files. Again, this is a 2-mark question, or if you are lucky, you can get this question for your 5-mark also. Now, type of data files. Normally, we store the files. In which format will it be stored? That is what is important. So, there are two types of data files here. One is your text file, and the other is your binary file. So there are two types of files, text file and binary file. Now what do you mean by this text file? Text file means it stores the information. It stores the information in ASCII characters. You already know what you mean by ASCII characters, right? ASCII means, what is the full form of ASCII? ASCII stands for American Standard for Standard Code for Information Interchange. So it stores the information in ASCII characters. And one thing that you have to remember here is, in a text file, it has a delimiter. That is, all the text, each and every line of the text should be terminated with a special character by, that is EOL, that is end of line. You have to tell that we have reached the end of the line. When we are saying that you have reached the end of the line, the compiler will take or translate in the compiler after each and every line. So when this EOL character is encountered, internal translation takes place. So remember, a text file should always end with the EOF character. Next, binary file. Now, what do you mean by this binary file? It is a file that contains the information in, it stores the information in binary form. You know, binary means it is zeros and ones. Zeros and ones is nothing but your machine language that the computer understands. So no internal translation is required, because the compiler or the system understands the machine language. That is, it's already in the form of zero and one. So binary file contains data in a machine language. So internal translation is not necessary. And also there is no delimiter, that is end of line is not required. Now, these are the two different types of data files that you are going to make use of. Now, the next important thing that you are supposed to remember is, if we are going, for example, if I am giving you the notes, what are you supposed to do? You are going to write the notes. So, when will you write the notes? You are going to write the notes by opening your book. You have to open the book to write the notes. So if you have to do that, opening part is very necessary. If you are closing the book inside and keeping it in your bag, you cannot write the notes. So opening is an important part. So the next part is opening a file. In the same way, in files also you have your opening. So but if you are opening a book, you can open a book either to read, or you may open it to write, or you may open it to continue writing your notes, start from the beginning, or continue what you had done in the last session, anything, right? In the same way, a file can be opened for different purpose. That is your writing or reading or appending, that is adding or making changes, anything. So So the stream objects, you have to create a stream objects before opening a file, depending upon the type of access you need. You have to tell, are you going to open the file for reading, or are you going to open the file for writing purpose, or are you going to open the file for adding anything. So to create an input stream, you have to declare that as a if stream. In the same way, you have to create an output stream. You already know what you mean by input stream and output stream. Input stream is for reading purpose. Output stream means for writing purpose. So that is what you have to tell. If you are going to use for reading purpose, you have to open the if stream. If you want to open it for writing purpose, then you have to declare it as off stream. And if you want to both read and write, then you have to declare it as input output operations, that is your F stream. Okay, so once a stream has created, then you can do the next thing that you want to do. So a file can be opened in two ways. Now you know why you have to open a file. So you can open a file in two ways. That is, one is using a constructor function. And again, remember, this is an important 3-mark question. Using a construction function of the stream class. That is one way of opening a file. And the next is here using the function open. You are just telling it to open. That is another way of opening a file. Now, let us see opening a file using constructor. Okay, now you already know what a constructor is. Constructor means it is used to initialize, that is, give a value in the beginning. It is used for initialization purpose of a object of its class as soon as it is created. Similarly, the constructor of stream classes also will initialize the file stream objects with the file names. You are going to initialize with the file names. That is, the file names has to be given in the beginning itself. So to open a file, if you want to open any file as an input file, you have to create a file stream object of input type. And the object also must be attached to the file name. Now, for example, just let us go for a syntax first. The syntax of stream, that is, next year file object and your file name. Example of stream, and this is just a object, it's an output. O means output, right? So you're just mentioning it as out file. You just give a any name, file name for your file. So what happens here? You are going creating an object, that is your out file. Okay, this is an object. You are creating an object of the stream output. This is your file stream for output purpose. So, and with the name of that file is name.txt. This is your file name. So you are going to open a file by the name of name.txt for output purpose. This is what you mean by your opening a file using your constructor. You are telling it in the beginning itself. Okay, next part is your get and put for files. Get and put for file. So you know what you mean by get and put. Get is used for input purpose and put is used for output purpose, right? Both are present in the IO stream.h file. So these functions are used to access a single character. Remember, they are used to access your single character. Get is used to read the single character. It is used to read the single character from a file through an input object, naturally. And put function is used to write a single character. It is used to write a single character into a file. This is from a file and this is into a file through the output object. This is through the input object and this is through your output object. That is the function of your input file, sorry, get and put functions for single input and output. And next is your next section is your opening, or the next type is your next using opening your files using the open function. So sometimes you may need to open more than one file also, depending on what work you are using. In such a case, you need to use a separate stream for each file. So open method, it will accept two arguments. It accepts two arguments, that is the file name and the mode. So file name, you already know, mode means for what are you going to open that file. Are you going to open it for your write purpose or reading purpose or appending purpose, whatever it is. So the file name is a unique identifier for a file, and the second argument, that is a mode, signifies the purpose of opening a file. Now let us end this session. Now let us continue in the next